Bearden Bears fans, question on the table today. Should the Chicago Bears be back in on bringing Leonard Floyd back? We'll talk about that, what he could bring to the team, and if he'd even want to come back on today's episode of the Windy City Breeze Sports Talk Daily. Let's go. Now, if you are new to the channel, please like the video. Please subscribe to the page, man. We do talk Chicago sports daily on this channel. It's the only channel talking Chicago sports, how Chicago talk. So make sure that you get in tune with us, man. So the Bears need an edge rusher. And surprisingly enough, the market is not bad, right? We've got some really good names on the market. We'll talk about a bunch of them that maybe the Bears could bring back, break them down into individual videos, different stuff like that. Expanding the content. Yeah, I'm talking about. But the one name that had to be first on this list is a name that was drafted here to this city and left on not great terms, right? So the question on the table today, should the Chicago Bears bring back Leonard Floyd? Now, when Leonard Floyd was here in Chicago, his first season was really effective, right? Seven sack season, didn't have a ton of combined tackles, 33 combined tackles, 23 solo tackles, 10 assisted, 9 QB hits though, was really good at getting into the backfield, right? But then things started to change, went from left outside linebacker to right outside linebacker. Khalil Mack shows up and you're thinking that it's going to be all kumbaya, but we instantly saw Leonard Floyd start to take a dip, going from 7 sacks to 4.5, continuing to drop to 4, and then finally 3 before he was finally sent out of here. But the one thing about Leonard Floyd that we do need to talk about is the fact that over the last 6 seasons, Leonard Floyd has been not only dominant in the last 3, but the pinnacle of health over those last 6. He's played 16 out of 16, 16 out of 16, 16 out of 16, 17 out of 17, 17 out of 17. So you're getting somebody who at a minimum is going to be on the field. And that does go back to his time with the Bears as well. Who's going to be on the field, who's going to be healthy, who's going to play through all the nagging injuries and different things like that. That's a good mindset that you want to have for your a player who's going to be a premier edge rusher on your defensive end. The real question is, right, is he going to be able to give you those that same production? His last 3 seasons, 10.5 sacks, 9.5 and 9, while working with Aaron Donald in the middle. Here's the thing that we do have to keep in mind, though. We don't have Aaron Donald. Aaron Donald does not play here. He is not... There's nobody who's even close to Aaron Donald on this defense. So you have to think, how effective is Leonard Floyd going to be if he's basically your premier high number pass rusher? And is he going to be able to be as effective as he was out with the Rams? Let me know how you guys are feeling about Leonard Floyd coming back to Chicago in the comments below. I've been down there talking with you as well. This is an interesting one, man, because to me, right, when you look at Leonard Floyd, I like the numbers. I like the production that he's given. I like what he's done standing next to Aaron Donald, but why couldn't he do that when Khalil Mack was here, when Akeem Hicks was here, when we did have that defense that was really stout and really vaunted? I mean, even in the 2018 season, right, he really was kind of a non-factor, played 16 games, only had 4 sacks. That's one of the best defenses in history as far as sack numbers and interceptions and things like that. And one of the best defenses in Chicago Bears history outside of 85 and 2005. Right. So you're looking at, to me, I look at that and I say, why couldn't you get it done there? But maybe, right, like there's something that he went to LA and it just clicked for him. There was something that changed in his game. You saw him getting to the quarterback, saw him pinning his ears back. He also, the difference is also, right, we were winning a lot of those games. And when you're winning a lot of those games, a guy like Leonard Floyd can just say, my job right now is to get to the quarterback. And when he was here in Chicago, right, you're kind of playing back. They were dropping him back in coverage some. They were trying to use that ability as well. And I just think that wasn't possibly what he was best suited for here in Chicago. Now, again, he was playing in a 3-4 defense as well. So maybe now coming back into a 4-3 defense, being with Coach Flus and different things like that, would be able to maintain that aggressiveness, that strong pass rush that he showed out in LA. You also have to take into account the fact that he is 30 years old coming back. Would he be the best value for the Chicago Bears right now? Because I don't think the Bears want to to go out here and get a one-year deal. I talked with Courtney Cronin on the Chicago Bears podcast last season, and she said she doesn't believe that the Bears are looking for a one-year plug-this-guy-in guy on the defensive line, right? She thinks they want somebody that is going to be here for a couple of years and is going to be an actual piece of this defense moving forward. Is Leonard Floyd going to be that? And I think the final question you have to ask is, what kind of money is he going to ask for? What kind of money is he looking for? There's a reason that he's still on the market. It's probably because he's asking for a certain price that the market at this point is not willing to pay. Now, the final thing that I do have to ask when it comes to Leonard Floyd, would he want to come here? That's the real question for me. And that's the question, going to be the question for every single one of these guys. Would he want to come here? The one thing that I will say that Floyd might have realized, right, is when you're making good plays on the defense, this city loves you. But we're going to call you out when you're not making those plays. I don't know if he wants to be back in this environment. The one thing that we do have going for us is a completely different coaching staff, completely different regime, completely different defensive coaches in here, right? You're not talking about the same old jokes that were here when Matt Nagy was here. You're not talking about the same old leadership that was here when Ryan Pace was here. Now you're talking about a completely different regime of guys in here, and it seems like there's a little bit more structure. Maybe coming back now would be a good move for him because you're able to rebuild yourself in a major city like you did in LA, right, and just keep that brand name up. And coming here, you, right, like the other team that has been talked about is Philly. Going to Philly, you're a guy on Philly. You're a guy that plays the edge on Philly. You're a left outside linebacker on Philly. It is what you are, right? Which is fine. It's not a big deal. Listen, you're going to go to a team that's going to win a lot of games. Coming here, you would be the man. So the real question is, do you want to be the man? Do you feel confident about how you've played your game enough to be the man? Because you're going to come here, you're going to be the highest paid guy probably on that defensive line. You'd be the highest paid guy on that defensive line. And you're going to look at what Leonard or teams are going to look at you and say, okay, that's the guy that we have to keep away from our quarterback. We're going to do everything we can to keep him away from our quarterback. And the situation is going to be very different, right? Again, there's no Aaron Donald. There's not even an Akeem Hicks or a Khalil Mack here right now. You're coming in with a rookie and Javon Dexter and or Zach Pickens playing your nose tackle, three technique. You're also coming in with DeMarcus Walker on one edge. You've got Dominique Robinson. You got Travis Gibson. Those are not the same guys. But I do think that it's good that some of those relationships that were once here, like Travis Gibson with Leonard Floyd, are still here. So maybe you can work something out there. At the end of the day, do I think the Chicago Bears should be in on Leonard Floyd? I'm a be honest with you, I think that it would be outside of or it would be a negligence on Ryan Pace to not at least kick the tires on Leonard Floyd. I don't know what kind of price he's asking for, but to me, right, like I think that he could be that linchpin piece. If you believe in what your rookies are going to do this season, if you believe in Javon Dexter, if you believe in Zach Pickens, how those guys are going to attack, I don't know, right, what they're going to do on the field. But again, that nose tackle position is the most important position, or I'm sorry, the three technique is the most important position of this defense. And so, right, if you believe that these guys are going to come out and be wreckers in season one, and you just need some edges on the outside, because I mean, realistically, you're literally just talking about Travis Gibson and Dominique Robinson. Those are your only real edges that you have on this team right now. So you're going to need to go out and get some premier guys. You're going to need to go out and spend some money. I don't think the Bears will have problem spending money or outspending whatever team is trying to get Leonard Floyd in here, because I don't think it's going to be a five-year deal for Leonard Floyd. But I do think that the Bears aren't going to sit there and overpay when the market is what it is right now, right? You got Frank Clark on the market. You've got Yannick Ngakoue on the market. You've got guys that you can go after. I think Leonard Floyd would be a really good piece for the Bears to go out there and get, but I think that there are options that the Bears can weigh here, and if Leonard Floyd's price is too high, the Bears don't have to go to that price. I do want to know how you guys feel, man. Let me know in the comments below. I'll be down there talking with you as well. As always, man, it's your boy Pat the Designer back at it again. Make sure to tune in to today's episode of the Chicago Bears podcast. Going to be me and Mark Silverman. Drop some questions for Sylvie in the comments below. We'll be doing all kinds of Bears talk over there as well. As always, man, y'all stay safe out there, Chicago. Appreciate all the love that you guys have shown me over the last couple of weeks, man. Peace. Oh, yeah. And we broke 18K. Drop a bird down if you made it to the end of the video. Peace.